I don't remember my dream. Now, if you will not tell me what my dream was, I will cut you off. You can see this king is like, now, this is an interesting response in verse 6. He goes, if you will show me the dream, I will give you a gift. So this is reward and punishment system. And this is not a good system, by the way. We teach this to our children. I say this because I'm taking care of a friend's nephew. We do punishment and reward system. It's mostly punishment. If you don't do this, I will do this to you, or you will be given. We teach people on the basis of fear. The same thing with in school. I mean, we're so ingrained in the system that we don't realize how bad it is. It's like, you don't study, you will fail. I mean, it makes sense, basically. But we're so ingrained in the system, we don't realize that it's not a system. But as usual, Nebuchadnezzar does that. And look at the response in verse 7. The king tells, they respond to what he says. You know, tell us your dream. And we will tell you the interpretation. So imagine the scene. I have a dream, I have a dream, and the system disturbs me. And one group says, in response, oh, tell us the dream, and we will interpret it. And then the king says, problem is, I can't remember.
Babylonian,
so then his reaction is that he's so angry, he's so furious, that he makes a decree that everyone has to be killed. This includes Daniel and his friends, by the way. Because it says, all the wise men of Babylon. Now, so in verse 14, it tells us that Barak, the captain, is about to enter and Daniel. Now, Daniel asks, what happened? Why is this decree so hasty? And then Barak tells the king, tells Daniel, this is what happened. Now, you have to appreciate Daniel. Now, he's very angry. He thinks all the wise men are charlatans, meaning be lying to him. Daniel requests to go to see the king. See, when my parents are angry, my first instinct after this movie not to be married. Because I'm going to get more of it. So the first reaction is when you're with angry people, my first reaction, I mean, whether it's my friends, if I know they're angry, I don't go near them. But he, God has given him the courage to face him. That takes courage. That's why I appreciate him not to be afraid, because it's like, Daniel, he's putting his life on the line by pushing the king in his anger. And so, he goes in, and you have to also give credit to King Nebuchadnezzar, because in verse 16, Daniel asks for time. The king gives it to him. Think about that. He just said, everyone be killed, and yet this man says, can you not? Can you not do this? Can we just give me time and not do what you ask us? You've been asking the wise men to do. So there must have been a certain relationship between King Nebuchadnezzar and Daniel, for him to trust Daniel. Believe that Daniel can do something. And remember, he's angry. So, there has to be a special bond between Daniel for him to do this. And the first thing he did in verse 17, after he gets permission, he goes to his friends and lands to pray. This is what makes Christianity. Many of us do not go to our friends when we're in trouble. We take the burden. I mean, it is good to be praying to God, but it's even better to get others to pray. Remember that when you're in trouble, like, this is the emphasis on this. Always go to people who you know are praying. And not just only just you know the folks that will intercede. I will continuously pray. And I'm blessed by friends. I have friends like that. You don't have to have many. One, two, three. Here, there's one here. Enjoy that. But there's some things in my life when I ask people to pray, I don't think it comes to me. I don't try. There's some people who do massive emails and all that. It's okay, it's fine. But it's really like, this is a life and death situation. You have those who are really. You also be a prayer warrior yourself. Don't live off the prayers of your friends. Honestly, I definitely do. So he gets his friends to pray. Then, the result of this, God blessed their prayers. Revealed to them in the dream. How many of you have dreams? Well, me, I have dreams because I ate dinner and it's too expensive. And dreams are really pretty. Affected by my third meal. How many of you dreams where it's like, sometimes you think, is this really a dream? Because for me, most of my dreams is because of my third meal and I watch something horrible or something, or I'm stressed about something. And so in the dream, it becomes really, really weird. But I have a dream I remember that I was facing a problem and I could not solve it. And God used that he used the dream to show me his solution to the problem. I remember waking up, wow, it's the first time God has ever done that to me. Like, oh, the solution is basically this. So yeah, in Joel, he says, God will speak to a young man who will do dreams. But be very careful, always check it's just a dream, the first thing Daniel does is that freezes him. Daniel to always freeze him. In all things, give thanks. And I like this verse in 21. It says, whatever politics you may see in the world, whatever you may see in your school, in your church, whatever politics, never God can listen to you anymore. No, I always tend to forget that because I have a very negative reaction to some presidents with what their policies are. God keeps reminding me. I allow them to be there. You have to fulfill a purpose that you do not have. So I'm going to ask you, who was that president before Gloria?
Fidel Ramos.
No, the first was Fidel Ramos. The second was the actor guy. Right? I don't know how your reaction is, but I had a Filipino who really ate it. She's like, and he was perceived to be corrupt and all that stuff. But through the experience of looking, whether it's a government leader, church leader, or whatever, God plays a chaos. So this is the answer to our enemies. So Daniel in verse 21 to 22, 22 gives all the credit to God. In 24, I like what happens here. So he tells the captain, he doesn't go directly to the king. He tells the captain, he's like, I already have the answer, so don't destroy the wise men. In verse 25, this man, Uriah, tells the king, I found someone. And he's a captain of the, from Judah, and he can make known to you what you want to know. This is the danger of taking credit that does not belong to you. Our greatest failure is always taking credit that does not belong to us. And we usually do that to God. Honestly, when we give testimonies, we talk more of ourselves than more of God. In my ministry, I work a lot with non-advocates. When they give praises, it's so interesting, it's so different from advocates. Everything is about God. Whereas when we give testimony, it's always like almost a sermon. And then you are better than the others. And then God is so good that you're better than the others. This one thing I noticed, I catch myself having to, I better not do this too. Let's not be like Miriam. When God does something for us, we always give the credit to God. And a way to help, I will tell you something. This is one way to help speakers, especially myself. Don't always praise us, okay? When you come up to us and say, praise God for the message, say that to God. Don't praise them. No brothers and sisters. The magicians, none of the wise men. So
he's basically making the others look good.
Because they told him already. It was like, what you ask, King? No one can do it except gods. He already said it to him. And so now he's acknowledging what they said. So in many ways, he's also helping them. Just because you may not like something supreme, that doesn't stop you from helping God. Seriously, I'm struggling with that too. There's some people I don't like, and I should not stop myself from helping them. That's why I say he's a humble man. And he gives the acknowledgement and wisdom, and the person who can do this is God. He's talking about his God, not the gods of what the wise man is saying. He's talking about only one person who can do this. No man can do this with God. So, and he goes to verse 30, you notice, but as for me, this secret is not revealed to me for any wisdom that I have. He's even saying all the wisdom that I have is not the reason why God is revealing this to me. And this is like what? He's probably, when he was taken captive, he was either 16, 17, 18. 3 years have passed. He's what? 21. At 21 years old, 22, he's telling a king, this is not revealed to me because I'm wise. See? But it's for the sake of the others to show who is God.
Stone came out of the mountain, but no hands were seen.